Here is a common pitfall that even experienced users sometimes overlook. Picture this. You've got a table full of sales data. Your boss swings by and asks you to tell who the top 3 employees are by total sales. Seems like an easy task, right? If you are familiar with pivot tables, you might go straight into insert, pivot table, the usual routine. You drag employee name into rows, sales into values, sort by total sales in descending order. Boom, there it is. Top 3 names, done. Except not done. Let's test the answer. And nope, it's completely wrong. So what happened? Let's rewind a step and examine what the pivot table actually did. The core mistake here was using the employee name instead of the employee ID. And trust me, that can cause some serious trouble. Why is using ID so important? Because names can change, IDs shouldn't. Here is an example. Two employees legally changed their names a few years ago, but their ID stayed the same, because it's unique and consistent. On the flip side, here are two different employees with the exact same name. Yep, same spelling, same formatting, but totally different people. That kind of thing can quietly mess up your reports. So when you are working with real-world messy human data, always start with the assumption that it needs cleaning, especially if you are dealing with Excel files or manually managed tables. So how do we get the right result? Let's use Power Query for this one. Select the table and go to Data, From Table Range. Step 1. Group the data properly. Click Group By button on the Transform tab. We'll group by employee ID, not name. Choose all rows for the operation. And I'll give the nested table a name, like X, as a placeholder. Step number 2. Figure out the latest actual name. One way is to sort the data in descending order by date, and then take the first row. We have a formula. The underscore symbol is a placeholder for our table. You can delete everything after it. Let's look at that part in detail. Inside the nested table, we'll apply table sort by date in descending order. This sorts each mini table from newest to oldest. Now we just need to extract the first record, the one with the most recent name. So we wrap it with table first. You will also need to specify the column name using square brackets, like this. Voila, we've got the latest name for each employee. And hey, while we are here, you can do any number of calculations in this same group by step. So I'll wrap the name logic like this, in square brackets. Then add total sales for each person with this list sum underscore sales. Now we have everything we need, so go ahead and expand both columns. And don't forget to sort by total sales in descending order. Let's try it now. Now we've got the correct top 3 employees using clean and reliable data. And the key lesson: it's so much better to learn these things before they bite you. And I'm curious, have you ever run into a situation like this, where a report looked right, but actually wasn't?